Welcome to today's maths class, and today we'll do basic geometrical ideas. Our learning objectives are point, line, line segment, ray, plane, curve, angle, triangle, quadrilaterals, and circle. The word geometry has been derived from the Greek word geo, that means earth, and matron meaning measure. Geometry is one of the branches of mathematics that deal with the measurement or construction of figures. Three geometrical terms, namely point, line and plane, form the foundation of geometry. We will learn about them in this chapter. First is point. A point determines the exact location of a space. किसी भी चीज के exact location को हम point से बताते हैं. A point is the shortest space that can be imagined, such as the short space cannot be measured in terms of length, breadth and thickness. However, to express the point, we can use some models for the point. There are some pointed end of the needle and the sharpened end of point, pencil, the tip of the compass, etc. To be rather practical in our study, the shape we need approximate model on the paper sheet. We show a point by the tiny dot on the paper marked by the sharpened end of the pencil. Sharpen the tip, thinner will be the dot. Jitni pencil ki tip sharp hogi, utna hi dot kya hoga, thinner hoga. The almost invisible tiny dot gives the idea of the point on a paper of sheet. When we mark several points on the paper, we need to distinguish them. To do the needful, we denote them by the single capital letter A, B, C, P, Q, R, X, Y, Z. We read the names of the point A, point B, point C, etc. Next is line. Line. A line is a set of points that extend endlessly in the both the direction. Clear? It has only length, no width. It has no end point. It has no fixed length. A line can be denoted by the both side arrow, that is the symbol of line. So line, both side arrow means we can extend it endlessly in both the direction. So iski koi fixed length nahi hoti. Next is types of lines. First is intersecting line. When two lines meet or cross a point, they are called the intersecting line. The common point is called the point of intersection. Like here, line AB and DC. Ek dusre ko point O pe cut kar rahi hai, so this is the point of intersection. Clear? Next is node. Only one line can be passing through any two points, such as through the point P and Q. Only one line can be drawn. So two points are okay, we can draw only one line. Infinite number of line can be drawn through the one point as shown in the figure. Through the point O, many lines can be drawn. So one point se we can draw many lines. Clear? Next is concurrent lines. Three or more lines which intersect at one common point are called the concurrent lines, and the point of intersection is called the point of concurrency. In the given figure, A, B, C, D, P, Q, R, S are the passing through the same point O, so these lines are called concurrent line, and point O is called the point of concurrency. Like here, is point pe intersect kar rahi hai sari lines, so this point is known as the point of concurrency. And these lines are known as concurrent lines. Clear? Next is parallel lines. The lines that do not intersect each other at all, however far they extend, they call parallel lines. The perpendicular distance between two parallel lines always remain the same. Parallel lines are represented by the symbol. This is the symbol of parallel. In the given figure, line AB and parallel to line CD, that represent AB parallel to CD. In parallel lines, the perpendicular distance between the two lines remains same. They will never intersect each other, however or how far we extend them. Clear? Next is perpendicular lines. Two intersecting lines are said to be perpendicular lines if they form the angle of 90 degrees with each other. The symbol for the perpendicular line is this is the line symbol for the perpendicular line. Clear? In the given figure, PQ is perpendicular to RS and RS is perpendicular to PQ since the line PQ and RS intersect each other at 90 degree. So here, PQ and RS, यहाँ पे intersect कर रहे हैं इस point पे Q point पे and यहाँ पे 90 degree angle form हो रहा है. So they are known as perpendicular lines. Clear? Next is line segment. Segment means a part of something. The line segment is a part of line. It has two end point and the length can be measured. It also is one dimensional. It is denoted by AB. So here AB, this is a line segment. It has definite length. Two end point honge AB. Clear? So AB kya hai yahan pe? AB, that is a line segment. Means ek kisi bhi line ka ek part hai. So, इसके क्या होगी? Definite length होगी and two end points होंगे. Clear? Next is ray. The ray is a part of line. It has one end point and can be extended in one direction only. So, here ray है, that is also part of line, but it has one end point and one side arrow होगा. That shows that it can be extended in one direction endlessly. It is denoted by AB ray, I mean one side arrow, that shows the ray. End point and one other point. Clear? Like here, the ray AB or yahan pe ray kya ho jayegi? PQ. We cannot write QP. We'll write PQ. Clear? Next is difference between line, line segment and ray. First is line. It does not have definite length. Line segment have definite length. The ray, it does not have a definite length. Line, it has no end point. Line segment have two end point and the ray has only one end point. Line, it cannot be drawn on the paper. We can simply represent it. Line segment, we can draw on paper. Ray, again, we cannot draw on paper. We can simply represent it. This is the symbol, both side arrow that represent a line. This is symbol of line segment. Two end point and one side arrow that represent a ray. AB and BA represent the same line. AB and BA represent the same line segment, but AB and BA represent two different rays. Clear? Next is a plane. Every solid object have a surface that may be curved or flat. For example, the surface of the ball is curved and the surface of the tabletop is flat. Any flat, smooth surface extend endlessly in all the direction, the length and breadth is called the plane. A plane does not have thickness. We cannot see and draw a plane completely. We see or draw the portion or the part of the plane. For example, the tabletop, blackboard, ceiling of a room, base of a cylinder, the page of a notebook. All these are the example of planes. But conventionally, we use the word plane for the part of plane. Part of plane ke liye use kar rahe hain hum yahan pe plane because pure plane ko we cannot draw on the paper. Clear? A plane also have infinite points, but the infinite number of points in a plane is very much larger than the infinite number of points in a line. We can draw only a portion of plane and usually represent it by the rectangular or a parallelogram. The plane is named by marking 3 points, not in a straight line. Clear? So this is the plane ABC. Clear? Collinear points. Three or more points in a plane said to be collinear if they are on the same line, like here. The point A, B and C, they are collinear, but point D and E are not collinear with A, B and C because they are not in the same line. Clear? Next is noid. Point which do not lie on the same line are called non-collinear point. Like here, point D and E are non-collinear points. Next is exercise 9.1. Name all the rays in the figure. As you know, ray have one end point and it can be extended in one direction endlessly. So here the ray are B, A,
दैट इज अ रे. क्लियर. सी ए इज अ रे एंड डी ए सिमिलरली यू कैन नेम द रे ए डी बी डी एंड सी डी. क्लियर. सो प्रैक्टिस ऑल द क्वेश्चंस ऑफ दिस एक्सरसाइज. नेक्स्ट इज कर्व्स. टेक अ पेंसिल ऑन अ पेपर. पुट द शार्प टिप ऑफ द पेंसिल ऑन द पेपर विदाउट लिफ्टिंग इट. मूव इट एमलेसली फ्रॉम वन पॉइंट टू द अदर. द फिगर सो ऑब्टेन्ड कैन बी इन एनी वन ऑफ द शेप. इस तरीके से आप करेंगे सो यू विल गेट दिस काइंड ऑफ फिगर. 1, 2, 3 और 4. क्लियर. सो ऑल दीज फिगर्स आर कॉल्ड कर्व्स. दीज फिगर्स आर कॉल्ड कर्व्स. सिमिलरली इफ यू टेक अ पीस ऑफ पेपर एंड इट इज जस्ट डूडल देन द पिक्चर ऑब्टेन्ड एज द रिजल्ट ऑफ डूडलिंग आर कॉल्ड द कर्व्स. एन ओपन कर्व हैज टू डिस्टिंक्ट एंड पॉइंट. फिगर 1, 2, 3. लाइक हियर फिगर 1, 2 एंड 3. इट हैव टू डिस्टिंक्ट पॉइंट. इनका जो स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट है एंड एंड पॉइंट दैट विल बी डिफरेंट. सो दे आर ओपन कर्व. इन क्लोज कर्व स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट एंड एंड पॉइंट विल बी सेम. अ कर्व दैट एंड वेयर इट बिगिन इज कॉल्ड द क्लोज कर्व. लाइक इन फिगर 4, 5 एंड 6. दे आर क्लोज कर्व. क्लियर. अ कर्व विच डज नॉट क्रॉस सेल्फ इज कॉल्ड द सिंपल कर्व. फिगर ए एंड बी. फिगर सी एंड डी आर नॉट सिंपल कर्व. A curve which is simple and closed both, that is called simple closed curve. Figure E and F. So, A and B are example of simple curve. C and D are not simple curve because ये क्या कर रहे हैं? They are cross each other. And E and F, they are example of simple closed curve. Clear? Next is know it. The closed curve that do not cross themselves are called simple curve and the curve that cross themselves are called complex curves. Next is interior and exterior of a curve. A compound wall separated your house from the road. You talk about the inside the compound, on the boundary of the compound and outside of the compound. In a closed curve, thus there are three distinct parts. First, interior of the curve means inside of the curve. Next, boundary means on the curve. And third is exterior means outside of curve. Clear? In the side figure, point P is in the interior, point Q is on the curve and point R is the exterior of curve. The interior of curve together with its boundary is called the region. Like here, P is in interior, Q is on the curve and R is outside the curve. The region including inside the curve and on the curve. Interior of the curve together with its boundary, that is called its region. Clear? Next is polygon. The term polygon is derived from the Greek word poly and gons, where poly means many. Poly ka matlab hota hai many. Gons means corner or angles. The polygons is the closed curve formed by the line segments such that no two line segment intersect except at their endpoint. Means koi bhi do line segment intersect nahi karenge except their endpoint ke alawa. No two line segment with the common endpoint are coincident. Clear? The लाइन सेगमेंट फॉर्मिंग द पॉलीगन आर कॉल्ड द साइड्स. जिनसे लाइन सेगमेंट जिससे पॉलीगन फॉर्म हो रहा है दैट इज कॉल्ड इट्स साइड्स. लाइक हियर ए बी बी सी सी डी डी ई एंड ई ए आर द साइड्स ऑफ द पॉलीगन ए बी सी डी. गिव्स इन द साइड फिगर द मीटिंग पॉइंट ऑफ द पेयर ऑफ द साइड इज कॉल्ड इट्स वर्टेक्स. इन द फिगर ए बी सी डी एंड ई दीज आर द वर्टिसेस ऑफ द Pentagon A B C D E. These are the sides ए बी बी सी डी सी डी ई एंड ई ए और ए दीज आर द साइड्स एंड दीज आर द वर्टिसेस ए बी सी डी ई फाइव लाइन सेगमेंट से मिलकर बनाया दिस इज अ पेंटागन ए बी सी डी ई नेक्स्ट इज एडजेसेंट साइड्स The two sides of the polygon have a common end point. They are called the adjacent side. In the figure AB BC, BC CD, CD DE, DE EA, EA AB are the five pair of adjacent side of the polygon ABCDE. So, adjacent sides kya hongi? Two sides of the polygon that have common end point. Like AB and BC are adjacent. AB and AE are adjacent. BC and DC are adjacent and BC and AB are adjacent. Like this, they have five pair of adjacent sides. Clear? Next is adjacent vertices. The end point of the same side of the polygon are called adjacent vertices in the figure AB, BC, CD, DE, EA are the five pair of adjacent vertices of the polygon ABCDE. A and D are not adjacent vertices because A and D are not the end point of the same height. Like here, A or B adjacent honge. B and C are adjacent, C and D are adjacent, D and E are adjacent, E and A are adjacent. Clear? Next is diagonals. The line segment joining the non-adjacent vertices is called the diagonals, joining the pair of vertices which are not adjacent. We get the diagonals of the polygon in the figure AD, BE, CE are diagonals. So, diagonals line segment which join non-adjacent vertices like E or B ko hum join karenge. So, that is a diagonal EB, DA, EC, DB. All these are diagonals. Clear? Like this, we can have CA also. Clear? Next is classifications of types of polygons. Polygons can be classified according to the number of sides. It is of two types. First is regular. In regular polygon, if all the sides of the polygon are of same length, then it is called regular polygon. Irregular. If the sides of the polygons are different length, then it is an irregular polygon. Agar side same hai, same length ki hai, it is called regular polygon. Different length hai, that it is called irregular polygon. Note. Name of the polygon and number of sides. In triangle, 3 sides. Quadrilateral, 4 sides. Pentagon, 5. Hexagon, 6 sides. Heptagon, 7. And octagon, 8 sides. Clear? Next is angles. An angle is formed by two rays with a common end point. The common end point is called the vertex of the angle and the two rays forming the angle is called the arm or side of the angle. An angle is represented by the symbol. This is the symbol of angle. In the given figure, OP and OQ are the arms and O is the vertex. An angle is written in different ways as angle O. Or we can write angle POQ or QOP. So, this is an angle two rays. OQ and OP are forming this angle. And their common end point, that point O, that is known as vertex. So, arms kya ho jayenge? OQ and OP and this is the vertex. So, we can name the angle QOP. Vertex, jo bhi point hoga, that will always come in the middle. So, we can name it QOP or POQ or simple angle O. Clear? Next is note. While we write the name of the angle, then the letter at the vertex is always written in the middle. Next is interior and exterior of an angle. An angle divides the plane into two parts. The part lying inside the angle POQ is called the interior of angle. And the point A, B, C, D, E, F, G, etc. lie inside the angle. The part that lies outside the angle is called exterior of angle. And the point x, y, n, z, m, etc. lie outside the angle. So you can see the point A, B, C, D, E, F, G. They are inside or interior of angle. Point x, y, z, n, m. They are outside the angle, means exterior of angle. Clear? Next is angle as rotation of rays. An angle can also be described by the rotating array. Let there array OP with the initial point O suppose. We rotate it and it occupies the final position OQ. We say that the angle POR or angle POQ has been described by rotating the ray O as the vertex. Like here. Suppose OP hai. This is the initial point. Then we'll rotate this point. And final position yahan pe. So this will form the angle. Ye jitna bhi hoga, that is the magnitude or measurement of angle. Next is magnitude. Magnitude of an angle is the amount of rotation which one of the arm undergoes about the vertex to coincide with the other arm. Means ye in dono arms ke beech mein jitna distance hoga, that is called magnitude. Yani measurement. Kitne degree ka angle hai, that is called magnitude. Next is adjacent angles. Two angles in a plane are said to be adjacent if they have the common vertex, a common arm. The other two non-common arm on the opposite sides of the common arm. In the given figure, POQ and QOR are the adjacent angle because they have the common vertex O, common arm OQ, the other two arm OP and OR are on the opposite sides of the common arm OQ. So here the angle QOP means this angle and ROQ, these are adjacent angle. Why? Because they have the common vertex O, common arm OQ and other two arm OR and OP are of opposite side. Clear? Next is linear pair. If the sum of two adjacent angles is 180 degree, then they are known as linear pair. Adjacent angle jinka sum 180 degree ho, they are known as linear pair. In the given figure, angle AOC and BOC form the linear pair because their sum is 180 degree. So here AOC and POC, ye kya ho jayenge? Linear pair, because inka sum kitna hai? 180 degree. They are adjacent and the sum is 180 degree, so they are linear pair. Next, we'll take an example. In the given diagram, name the point S in the interior of angle DOE. Interior of angle DOE. This is angle DOE. Iske interior mein point kaun kaun se hai? Point A and G. These are the interior of the angle DOE. Next is exercise 9.2. Identify each figure below as open figure or a closed figure. First one, that is a closed figure. Clear? So practice all the questions of this exercise. Next is triangle. A simple closed curve formed by the three line segment is called the triangle. A triangle is a polygon formed by three line segment. It is a polygon with the least number of side. Means, as a polygon, just the subse kam side, that is triangle. Mark the non-collinear point A, B, C of the sheet of paper. Draw all possible line segment. These line segment A, B, B, C and C, A. Thus, the polygon called triangle is formed by these three line segment, not two of which are in one straight line. A triangle can be named in six different ways. So here, three non-collinear points, because tino ek plane mein nahi hai, A, B and C will join them, so it will form a triangle. It has three sides, A, B, B, C and C, A. Three angles ho jayenge, angle 1, 2 and 3 and three vertices, A, B and C. So we can name this triangle in different ways. Triangle BC, triangle ACB, triangle BCA, triangle BAC, triangle CAB or triangle CBA. Clear? Next is vertices, sides and angles of triangle. Meeting point of the line AB, BC and CA are called the vertices of the angle ABC. Three line segment AB, BC and CA forming the triangle are called the sides of the triangle ABC. A triangle has three angles: angle BAC, angle ABC, angle BCA. We can also denote them as angle A, B and C, and sometimes as angle 1, 2 and 3. So these are the side I already told you. These are the side AB, BC and AC, and three angles: angle A, B and C. Clear? Next is interior, exterior and boundary of triangle. Note that triangle ABC means only the boundary of the figure, not the interior. The surface within the boundary of the triangle ABC is called the interior of the triangle ABC. The part of the plane is made by all the points enclosed by triangle ABC. In the figure, point P is in the interior of triangle ABC. The interior of triangle ABC along with the boundary, the triangle ABC itself, is called the triangular region ABC. In the figure, point R is on the boundary and the part of the plane made up by all such point as Q, which are not enclosed by the triangle ABC, is called the exterior of triangle or angle ABC. So here, point P is interior of triangle ABC, point R is on the triangle ABC and Q is outside, mean exterior of triangle ABC. So point P and R, the area enclosed by these points and point P, they will together make triangular region. Clear? Next is median of a triangle. Lines joining the midpoint of the side of the triangle opposite vertices is called the median of the triangle. Each triangle can have three medians. In the above figure, P, Q and R are the midpoint of side BC, AC and AB respectively. So AP divide the figure into two parts, hence AP is the median. Similarly, BQ and CR respectively divide the figure into two parts, therefore BQ and CR also median. So here AP, BQ and CR, these are the three medians of the triangle. Next is altitude of a triangle. The perpendicular drawn from the vertex of the triangle to its opposite sides is called an altitude of the triangle. Can have three altitude. In the figure, AD is perpendicular drawn from the vertex A to the opposite side BC is an altitude. Similarly, BE and CF are the altitudes drawn from the vertices B and C to the opposite side AC and AB respectively. So here, from the vertex AC, opposite side BC pe, this is the altitude, because make here 90 degree angle. So like this, three altitude can be drawn from point B, BE and from point C, CF. These are three altitudes of triangle. Clear? Next, note the point where the medians meet is called the centroid, and the point where the altitude of the triangle meet is called the orthocenter. Jahan pe bhi median, three medians hoti hai, they will meet, that point is called the centroid, and the point where altitude meets, that is known as orthocenter. Clear? Next is quadrilaterals. A quadrilateral is a closed figure bounded by four line segments. We can also say that the quadrilateral is the four-sided polygon. It has four sides, four vertices, four angles. The quadrilateral ABCD shown in the figure AB, BC, CD, DA are the four sides, and angle DAB, angle CBA, angle BCA and angle CDA are the four angles. ABCD are the four vertices. So here quad means four. A closed figure made up of four line segments, that is known as quadrilateral. So here, this is the quadrilateral ABCD. It has four sides: AB, BC, CD, and DA. These are the vertices AB, C, and डी एंड एंगल्स हो जाएंगे एंगल ए बी सी एंड डी. क्लियर. नेक्स्ट डायगोनल्स ऑफ क्वाड्रिलेटरल्स. द लाइन सेगमेंट जॉइनिंग द अपोजिट वर्टिसेस और द क्वाड्रिलेटरल आर कॉल्ड द डायगोनल्स. द क्वाड्रिलेटरल ए बी सी डी ए सी एंड बी डी आर द डायगोनल्स. सो हियर अपोजिट वर्टिसेस को ज्वाइन करके जो पॉइंट ज्वाइन करते हैं लाइन सेगमेंट दैट इज नोन एज डायगोनल. सो ए सी एंड बी डी दीज आर टू डायगोनल्स ऑफ क्वाड्रिलेटरल. क्लियर. नेक्स्ट इज एलिमेंट्स ऑफ द क्वाड्रिलेटरल. फर्स्ट इज एडजेसेंट साइड्स. टू साइड्स ऑफ द क्वाड्रिलेटरल विच हैव द कॉमन एंड पॉइंट्स आर कॉल्ड द एडजेसेंट साइड. इन क्वाड्रिलेटरल पी क्यू आर एस पी क्यू एंड क्यू आर. पी क्यू आर एस की बात करें सो पी क्यू एंड क्यू आर दे आर एडजेसेंट. क्यू आर क्यू आर एंड आर एस दे आर एडजेसेंट. पी एस एंड पी क्यू आर एडजेसेंट. क्लियर. पी एस की पी क्यू भी एडजेसेंट होगी एंड एस आर भी एडजेसेंट होगी. क्लियर. नेक्स्ट इज नो इट. डायगनल्स ऑफ द क्वाड्रिलेटरल डिवाइडेड टू फोर ट्राइंगल्स. जो डायगनल्स है क्वाड्रिलेटरल के उसको फोर ट्राइंगल में डिवाइड कर. नेक्स्ट इज ऑपोजिट साइड्स. टू साइड्स ऑफ द क्वाड्रिलेटरल विच डू नॉट हैव द कॉमन एंड पॉइंट आर कॉल्ड द ऑपोजिट साइड्स. इन क्वाड्रिलेटरल ए बी सी डी ए बी एंड डी सी बी सी एंड ए डी आर टू पेयर्स ऑफ ऑपोजिट साइड्स. सो इन दिस क्वाड्रिलेटरल ए बी सी डी ए बी एंड डी सी आर ऑपोजिट साइड्स एंड ए डी एंड बी सी आर ऑपोजिट साइड्स. नेक्स्ट इज एडजेसेंट एंगल्स. टू एंगल्स ऑफ द क्वाड्रिलेटरल विच हैव द कॉमन साइड्स आर कॉल्ड द एडजेसेंट एंगल. द क्वाड्रिलेटरल पी क्यू आर एस पी एंड क्यू क्यू एंड आर आर एंड एस एंड पी एंड एस आर फोर पेयर्स ऑफ एडजेसेंट एंगल्स. सो एडजेसेंट एंगल्स कौन से हो जाएंगे पास पास वाले यानी पी एंड क्यू. पी एंड क्यू बिकॉज दे हैव द कॉमन साइड्स एंड क्यू एंड आर आर एडजेसेंट आर एंड एस आर एडजेसेंट एस एंड पी आर एडजेसेंट. क्लियर. नेक्स्ट इज ऑपोजिट एंगल्स. Two angles of the quadrilateral that have not common side are called the opposite angle. The quadrilateral ABCD angle A and C, B and D are two pairs of opposite angle. A and C are opposite angle and B and D are opposite angle. Next is interior and exterior of quadrilateral. A quadrilateral divide the plane into three parts. The part inside the quadrilateral that is called interior of quadrilateral point P, Q, R and S. They lie in the interior of quadrilateral. The part outside the quadrilateral that is known as exterior of quadrilateral point K, L, M and N. They lie in the exterior of quadrilateral. Point G and H which is on the boundary of the quadrilateral are said to be on the quadrilateral. So point P, Q, R and S. They are interior of quadrilateral. G and H they are on the quadrilateral and point K, L, N and M they are exterior of quadrilateral. Next is convex and concave quadrilaterals. First is convex quadrilateral. A quadrilateral which the measure of each angle is less than 180 degree is called the convex quadrilateral. Convex quadrilateral mein each angle jo hota hai that is measure less than 180 degree. Also the point of the intersection of diagonals a convex quadrilateral lie inside the quadrilateral. The adjoining quadrilateral W, X, Y and Z is the convex quadrilateral. So this is the example of convex quadrilateral. Next is concave quadrilateral. A quadrilateral in which the measure of one of the angle is more than 180 degree but less than 360 degree is called the concave quadrilateral. Also in the concave quadrilateral the point of the intersection of the diagonals lie outside the quadrilateral. Jahan pe bhi जो डायगोनल्स है इंटरसेक्ट करेंगे इन कॉनकेव क्वाड्रिलेटरल दैट पॉइंट विल बी आउटसाइड. क्लियर. In the adjoining concave quadrilateral ABCD, angle C is more than 180 degree. Angle C jo hai, that is more than 180 degree but less than 360 degree. And the point of intersection of the diagonals O that lie outside the quadrilateral. So, this point O that is outside of quadrilateral, that is the point of intersection of diagonals. Clear? Next, note. In the line segment joining any two point in the interior quadrilateral does not lie wholly within it, then it is concave quadrilateral, otherwise it is convex quadrilateral. Next is angle sum property of the quadrilateral. Consider the quadrilateral ABCD. Draw the diagonal AC. Diagonal AC divide the quadrilateral into two triangles ADC and ABC. So here the diagonal AC that divide the quadrilateral into two triangle, triangle ABC, this one, and the triangle ADC, these two triangles. Clear? The diagonal AC divide the quadrilateral into two triangle ADC and ABC. Angle A equals to 1 plus 2. Angle A kisse milke banaya 1 and 2 ko. Angle C 3 plus 4. Now, we know that the sum of the angle of triangle, that is 180 degree. So, we will write angle 1 plus angle 3 plus D, 180 degree. Same here in this triangle, angle 2, 4 and B, that is 180 degree. Clear? Now, we will add our equations 3 and 4. So, we will get angle 1 plus angle 3 plus angle D plus angle 2 plus 4 plus B, that is 180 plus 180 degree. Clear? 1 and 2, that will form angle A. Clear? And 3 and 4, that will form the angle C. Or ye ho jayenge B and D. So, angle A plus B plus C plus D, that is equals to 180 plus 180, that is 360 degree. So, hence we get the sum of the angle of quadrilateral is 360 degree. Now, we will take an example. Three angles of the quadrilateral are 100 degree, 80 degree and 110 degree. Find the fourth angle. Let the fourth angle be x degree. As we know, the sum of the four angle of quadrilateral, that is 360 degree. So, x plus 100 plus 80 plus 110, that is equal to 360 degree. So, x equals to 360 minus 290, that is 70 degree. So, fourth angle is of 70 degree. Clear? Next is exercise 9.3. Which of the following figure are triangles? So, as we know, triangle is made up of three line segments. So, C and E are triangles. Clear? So, practice all the questions of this exercise. Next is circle. A circle is a simple closed curve whose boundary is made up of points which are at equal distance from the fixed point. Note, all the points on the circle are equidistant from the center of the circle. Jitne bhi point is boundary pe honge, that will be on equal distance from the center of the circle. Clear? First, center. The fixed point inside the circle which is equal distance from all the points on the circle is called the center of the circle. In the given figure, O is the center of the circle. Here the point O, that is the center of circle. Next is radius. The radius is the distance between the center to the any point on the boundary of the circle. In the given figure, OA, OB, OC are the radii, plural ho jayega radius of the circle. So, from the center to any point on the circle, that distance is radius. So, OA, OB and OC, these are the radius of the circle. Clear? Next, know it. All the radii of the circle are equal. Jitni bhi radii hongi circle ki, that will be equal. Next is chord. A line segment joining any two points on the circle is called the chord of the circle in the given figure. PQ, AB, CD are the chords of the circle. So the line segment that joining two points on the circle. So PQ is a chord, AB is a chord, CD is a chord. Know it. Diameter is the longest chord of the circle. Diameter kya hoti hai? That is the longest chord of the circle. Next is diameter. The line segment through the center of the circle and having its end point on the circle is called the diameter. In the given figure, AB is the diameter of the circle. In the given figure, OA and OB are the radii of the circle and AB is also the diameter of the same circle. So, in the given figure, you can see OA and OB that are the radii of the circle. OA and OB and diameter kya hogi? Center se pass hoti hai and it join two points on the circle. So, AB is the diameter of the circle. So, AB kiske equal hogi? 2OA or AB equals to 2OB. Means diameter is twice the length of the radius. Now we'll take an example. Find the diameter of the circle whose radius is 5 cm. As we know, diameter is twice of the radius. So diameter 2 into radius 2 into 5, that is 10 cm. Clear? Next is circumference. The length of the boundary of the circle, that is known as circumference. जो बाउंड्री की पूरी लेंथ होगी सर्कल की दैट इज नोन एज सर्कमफेरेंस. नेक्स्ट इज सेमी सर्कल. द डायमीटर डिवाइड द सर्कल इनटू टू इक्वल पार्ट. ईच पार्ट इज कॉल्ड द सेमी सर्कल. हियर द डायमीटर ए बी डिवाइड द सर्कल इनटू टू इक्वल पार्ट. सो ईच पार्ट इज नोन एज अ सेमी सर्कल. सो टू सेमी सर्कल. नेक्स्ट इज आर्क ऑफ द सर्कल. Any part of the circle is called an arc of the circle. An arc which is greater than the semicircle is called the major arc. In the given figure, ADB is a major arc. An arc which is less than the semicircle is called the minor arc. In the given figure, ACB is the minor arc. So, two arcs hai. Here you can see AD and B. That is the major arc and ACB, that is the minor arc. Clear? Next is segments of a circle. A segment is a part of the circle enclosed by the chord and an arc of the circle. The chord of the circle divided into two parts. The part which contains center of the circle is called the major segment. The part which does not contain the center of the circle is called minor segment. So here segment kya hoga? Means part. Segment means a part of the circle enclosed by the chord and arc. So two segments hoga. Minor segment, this is the minor segment which will not contain the center of the circle, and this is the major segment. Next is sector of a circle. The area bounded by an arc and two radii joining end of the arc with the center is called the sector. When the sector is formed with the minor arc, it is called the minor sector. When the sector is formed with the major arc, it is called major sector. So, two sectors ho jayenge. This is the major sector because it contains major arc and this is the minor sector. Clear? Next is scant. The line passing through the circle and intersecting the circle at two point is known as scant of the circle. In the given figure, PQ is the scant of circle. So, this line is known as scant of circle. Next is concentric circles. When two or more circles have the same center, that is called concentric circles as shown in the given figure. Two or more circles jinka center same hoga, that is known as the concentric circles. Clear? Next is interior and exterior of a circle. The circle divides all the points of the plane into three parts. The part of the plane consisting those points P and Q, which OP is less than R or OQ is less than R, is called the interior of the circle. द पार्ट ऑफ द प्लेन कंसिस्टिंग दोज पॉइंट सच एज ए फॉर विच ओ ए इक्वल्स टू आर दैट आर कॉल्ड द सर्कल इटसेल्फ द पार्ट ऑफ द प्लेन कंसिस्टिंग द पॉइंट आर एंड एस विच ओ आर इज मोर देन आर एंड ओ एस इज मोर देन आर आर कॉल्ड द एक्सटीरियर ऑफ द सर्कल सो ऑल दीज पॉइंट्स P and Q, that is the interior of the circle. Point A, that is on the circle, and R and S, that form the exterior of the circle. Next, we'll take an example. Refer to the adjoining figure and fill in the blanks. RS is the dash of the dash circle. So here, RS is the diameter of the inner circle. Clear? Next is exercise 9.4. Define the following. First is circumference. The boundary of the circle that is known as its circumference. Clear? So practice all the questions of this exercise. Next is summary. A point has no length, breadth or height. It is represented by a dot. Two lines having the common points are called the intersecting lines. The line has no end points and extended infinitely in both the direction. A line segment has two end points and it can be measured. The ray is the part of the line which has only one end point. Three or more points are said to be collinear if they lie on the same line in a plane. Clear? A plane is a flat and smooth surface that extends infinitely in all the direction. The figure whose endpoint is different from the initial point is called the open figure. The figure whose initial point and endpoint are same, that is called closed figure. A simple closed figure having three or more line segments is called the polygons. An angle is formed by two rays with the common initial point and extending in different direction. A triangle is closed figure bounded by the three line segment. A quadrilateral is a closed figure bounded by four line segment. A circle is a simple closed curve whose boundary is made up of the point which are equal distance from the fixed point. Multiple choice questions. Tick the correct options. How many lines can be drawn passing through the two given fixed point? So, from two given fixed point, we can draw only one line. Only one. So, A is the correct option here. Here we end the chapter. I hope you understand the chapter well. Now you do practice it.